Today, I want to talk to you about the four basic needs of a team member. Now, these are individuals in your ministry, and failing to meet these needs could result in restricted or limited contributions by this person to your team, and also restricted development. So let's take a look. The first thing that you want to look at is gifting. So how are you utilizing this person's gifts, their skills and abilities on your team? How do their unique abilities help your team, and are you calling those out and affirming those gifts? Next, we have acceptance. Now, are they accepted by you and by the other members on the team? Do the actions of other team members reflect this acceptance? Those are big things to consider. The third need is passion. And how do their passions align with the ministry? How do their passions align with the passions of the team? These things are also important for them feeling like they belong and they're part of that team. And finally, it's representation. Now, this one may sound a little interesting at first, but stick with me. How do they represent others who are not on the team? Do they feel allowed to be encouraged to freely share their perspective, their outside perspective, their insight? Are they able to contribute? Are they able to bring things from other places and spheres of their life and even groups that they're involved in into your ministry, whether that be inside or outside the church? So think about the people on your team and how well you are meeting these four needs. Are there areas that need to be addressed, whether those are individually or as a team? And who can help you better contribute to this on your team and as a whole in your ministry? Evaluate your team and decide what you are going to do about it.